before you. Tomato are rich in vitamin C and keeps our immunity strong. They also reduce heart disease. So friends, we should eat tomato daily. Thank you, ma'am.
Nutrition value. This is a carrot. Carrot is a root vegetable. It is a very healthy. Carrot are the best sources of vitamin A. It helps us to keep eyes, hair and skin healthy. We can eat carrot raw and cooked too. Thank you, ma'am.
Good morning. My name is Shubhi Dubey from class 1D. There are many vegetables in my basket. This is a potato. This is a cabbage. This is a lady finger. This is a garlic. This is the onion, this is the red chili, and this is the green chili, and this is the tomato. Tomato is a used vegetable. It is red in color. Tomato, it shine and smooth, and there are many small seeds. Tomato, different type of tomato. Tomato is a rich and a source of vitamin C and K. Tomatoes good for skin and eyelash. Thank you.
Good morning, ma'am. My name is Padmesh Karma from First F. An apple. This is an apple. Apple is a healthy fruit. It is said that an apple a day keeps the doctor away. Apple is a good source of fiber, vitamin C and minerals, which is very good for our health, good for our bone, good for our heart, good for our lungs. Apple promotes good gut bacteria. An apple prevent cancer, oxidize of we can make juice, jelly, jam from it. We should eat an apple every day. And is it apple is a red, green, pink and yellow in color. Thank you, ma'am.
It is sweet in taste. The color of apple is red, yellow and green. It is said that an apple a day keeps the doctor away. Apple is a healthy fruit. Apple is most eaten fruit worldwide. Apple come in many sizes. Thank you.
Good morning, everyone. My name is Aityado. I study in class 2nd section A. And today I am talking about healthy food and junk food. Healthy food contains important nutrients, proteins, vitamins, which are required our body. Healthy food also gives us energy to work, play, and other activities. Healthy food also helps us to stay healthy and fight diseases. Fruits, vegetables are some examples of healthy food. The food that are harmful for us are called junk food. Junk food, pizzas, burgers, chips, cold drinks are some examples of junk food, which it contains high amount of salt, sugar, oil and fats. We should not have too much junk food as we may fall ill. Thank you.
My name is Pushpal Sule from class 2nd B. Today I am presenting between four lines: healthy food and junk food. A healthy food: rice, wheat, vegetables, pulses and fruits are energy giving foods. Fruits and vegetables help us to fight our disease. Our milk is very good for our health. Next, a junk food. Junk food like pizza, burger, chips and cold drinks. Junk food is very harmful for our health. A junk food may be tasty, but he did not provide any nutrition to our body. Thank you.
Hello everyone, my name is Ashika Kapoor from class 2nd C. Today I am going to elaborate some differences between nutritious food and junk food. When we talk about nutritious food, it means healthy food, which are rich in nutrients like protein, carbohydrates, fibers, vitamins and minerals. A healthy food refers to a whole lot of fresh and natural products such as fruits and vegetables. It is help us to fight with many diseases and also make us strong. When we talk about junk food is the best example of unbalanced diet. Contains refined sugar and salt with low nutrients value like chips, cookies, cakes, cold drinks, pizza, burger. So, eat nutritious food to stay strong and healthy. Avoid junk food, it does make us sick. Thank you.
Hello ma'am, my name is Ranva Jekar. This is my small kitchen garden. This is aloe vera plant, this is chili plant, this is banana plant. I take care every day. Thank you, ma'am.
Good morning, ma'am. I am Ashmi Raghu. I study in class 7E. Today we are celebrating National Nutrition Month. First of all, I will explain you about junk food. Unhealthy foods are also called junk food. Most of the fast foods fall in this category, like oily spicy food, soft drink, pizza, butter, burger, etc. Unhealthy foods don't digest easily. They do not provide any nutrition to our body. Now I will explain you about healthy food. Healthy food is the requirement of our body. other nutrients from pulses. It helps to build our muscles. Now I will explain you calcium. We get calcium from milk. It's help to build and maintain strong bones. Vitamins and minerals from vegetables. It keeps us away from diseases. Carrot, tomato, capsicum, and cauliflower. Thank you.
My name is Vihanpal. I study in class 2nd F. I am going to tell something about nutritional food like fruits, dry fruits, vegetables, and grains. These are good for our health. And these are junk food. These are bad for our health. So eat healthy food and be healthy. And avoid eating junk food. Thank you. Have a nice day.
Hello guys, my name is Lisa Patel and I am from 5th day and my theme is Significance of Food. What is food? This is food. Food is the third most important thing for our life and to survive. The food gives us energy for activity, growth and features of our body, such as breathing, digesting food, and keeping warm. Food definitely relate to our body and mental and social health because each food or liquid contains a particular nutrients such as carbohydrates, minerals, proteins, vitamins, and etc. Thank you.
Good morning. Myself, Durganshi Sharma of class 5B, is here to present our chart on the topic nutrients. The useful energy-giving, bodybuilding or protective substances present in our food are called nutrients. Types of nutrients. There are 5 types of nutrients. The first is carbohydrate. We get carbohydrate from chocolate, sweets, honey, wheat, maize, potatoes, fruits and rice. The second is fat. We get fats from ghee, oil, cheese, nuts, meats and butter. The third is proteins. We get proteins from beans, fish, soya, meat and eggs. The fourth is minerals. We get minerals from milk, nuts, green leafy vegetables and fruits. The last is vitamins. There are 5 kinds of vitamins. The first is vitamin A. We get vitamin A from orange, tomato, carrot, green vegetables and eggs. The second is vitamin B. We get vitamin B from fish, meat, milk and green leafy vegetables. The third is vitamin C. We get vitamin C from citrus fruit and vegetables. The fourth vitamin.
I am Rakshya Bharti from class 50. I am going to explain about deficiency diseases. These diseases are caused by the lack of certain essential nutrients in one's diet over a prolonged period of time. Some common deficiency diseases are such as carbohydrate deficiency causes hypoglycemia, effects blurred vision, fatigue, etc. Protein deficiency causes kwashiorkor and marasmus. Effects swelling of feet and belly, malnutrition, etc. Iodine deficiency causes goiter, anemia, hypothyroidism. Effects swelling in neck area, weakness, poor growth. Vitamin A deficiency causes night blindness. Effects not being able to see at night could lead to complete blindness. Vitamin B deficiency causes beriberi, swollen feet and legs, pain in limbs, etc. Vitamin C deficiency causes gum bleeding and scurvy. Effects weakness, anemia, gingivitis. Vitamin D deficiency causes rickets, improper growth of bones. Effects weak bones, pain in limbs, deformity of bones, fracture. Thank you.
Good morning, ma'am. My name is Sanjay Malviya. I am from 5th D. My topic is significance of balanced diet. A balanced diet given our body the nutrients to function correct to get the nutrients our needs. Most of your daily calories should come from fresh fruits, vegetables, whole grains, legumes, nuts, meats, wheats, rice and nutrients, food. Thank you, ma'am.
Good morning, everyone. My name is Chetan Pathare from class 5th F. Today, I'm going to tell you about healthy eating habits. The food that you eat can be either the safest and the most powerful form of medicine or the slowest form of poison. Health is wealth. This is the golden rule. There are some healthy eating habits. We should follow them. We should eat more fruits and vegetables. We should drink plenty of water, especially during the summer season. We should wash our hands before and after eating the food. We should be physically active. It include outdoor games and exercise. We should not run after the shine glitter of packaged food. In the last, eat right and feel right. Thank you.
Good morning. My name is Shubh Raghavanshi from class 5th C and the topic is types of nutrient. First, carbohydrate. They are the primary source of energy to our body and they rich in rice. Second, fat. They are the second source of energy to our body after carbohydrate. The food that not be burnt is result as obesity and they rich in oil. Third, proteins. They repair our bones, muscles, blood, skin, and that's the reason they are called bodybuilding food. Example, soya, etc. Fourth, vitamin and minerals. They are the protective nutrients because they are in style for good health and they are rich in green vegetables and fruits. Thank you.
That particular vitamin tablet we are taking just for if we are lacking somewhere, okay? Or else generally from fruits and vegetables we are getting almost all the vitamins. The next thing is minerals, okay? Why minerals are necessary? Here you can see one more chart, okay? From which, what are the sources, what are the different types of vitamins, what are the sources of those vitamins? That you can see here. Okay. What are minerals? Again, minerals are very important to stay healthy. Okay, they keep our bones and muscles, heart and brain working properly. Okay, because of that reason, minerals are very much necessary. Okay, these are the food items which are rich in minerals. Okay. The different types of minerals are again there. Can you suggest some name of the minerals, some type of minerals?
Calcium.
Do you know some of the minerals name? Can you suggest? Children?
Vegetables
and fruits. Wait, I'm asking, I'm not asking the source. I'm asking, as you just now told me, vitamin A, vitamin B, vitamin C. In the same way, can you suggest the name of some of the minerals? Tell me fast.
Calcium,
iron, phosphorus, magnesium, copper, iodine, zinc, cobalt, chloride, sulfur, potassium, sodium, chloride, all these are the minerals which are necessary for our body. Keep it in your mind, okay? All these are the minerals which are necessary for our body.
What all garden you have and which all vegetables you have. Am I right? So this is clear to you, children?
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Very good. And what did you get from today's class? What all things you can share? Okay. So Mansira, what about what did you understand from today's class? That is,
we should never waste food.
Very good. We should never waste food. Why? Anushka, why should not we waste food? Why should not we waste food?
Because...
Yeah? We should not waste. How much amount of food we should take?
That's what we only have.
How much is required? You must take that. Yes, Shailja, do you want to share something? Yeah.
Eat vitamin A rich food. Okay. What happened when vitamin D, the lack of vitamin B happened? Just because of lack of vitamin B, what? Yes, it is very, very. Okay, so what happened exactly in that? What problems may happen? Vitamin C. What happens if the lack of vitamin C happened? What may happen? Tell me first. Just because of vitamin, lacking of vitamin, yeah, bleeding gums, okay? Just because of lacking of vitamin C, bleeding gums may happen, and because of vitamin D, rickets may happen, okay? Now I will go for the quiz. Are you all able to see my screen? Okay, we'll go for the quiz. Okay. You all have to read the question, and then you just now I introduce all the things what may happen and what are the impact if we not have proper amount of vitamins or if we not have balanced diet. What problems may happen? Now we cannot enjoy the life. Our health, we cannot improve our health, even the development and all the mentally retardation is also going on. So the first thing is, what is the significance of food? Food is the third most important thing after water and air. Water and air are most important than food, because without water and air we cannot even survive for a day. Without food, it is possible we can survive for a day or a week or a month. It is possible. But the main thing which we have to take every day, that is food, because it gives us energy. It is a basic need of the human body. It develops, it helps in development. It helps in the giving shape of our body. Also, food gives us energy. The nutrients which we are getting from the food are separate in all types of food. Means every food is having different types of nutrients. So what are the main nutrients? The main nutrients are carbohydrates, fats, vitamins, minerals, water and roughage. important. Keeping in this plate, why? Because they are the category of the different nutrients which we are taking in our daily diet for the development and growth of the body. These are the different foods. Some are rich in carbohydrates, some are rich in fats, some are rich in proteins. These are the sources of minerals and vitamins.
The next important the feature which is there in the food is the protein. Can anyone tell me in which food item you are finding the protein? Yes. Proteins are very good. So proteins are What is the very good. So what is the function of the protein? What does the protein do? Can anyone tell me? Yes, they repair the damaged cells of the body. That is the thing which it is doing. Then we'll see the another thing which is present in our body, that is the fat. Fat is also another source of energy and it also adds taste and texture to the food. Can anyone tell me in what food materials, some examples of food materials in which fat is available? Yes. Very good. Yes. So in all these things you have the fat content, that is the ghee. But remember, if excess fat is being consumed in your daily routine, that will lead to obesity. So you have to take the quantity in very minimum.
Are the nutrients that which provide energy as well as which build our tissues. Okay, there are different types of nutrients that are carbohydrate, fats, proteins, vitamins, minerals, and water. Okay, now carbohydrate. What are the uses of carbohydrate in our body? Why we should eat carbohydrate? Yes, exactly. Carbohydrate gives us energy, and because of that reason, it is also called as energy giving food. Okay, now what are the examples? Can you tell me two examples of energy giving food? Yes, it is rice, maize, these are wheat, potato, all these are, Yes, exactly, rice, wheat, potato, all these are the energy giving food. And when carbohydrate is made up of two things, that is starch and sugar. Okay, so from starch and sugar, we are getting instant energy, and because of that reason, during summer season, generally we are telling you to have glucose bottle along with you while you are coming to school. That is just because
have you had your breakfast? What did you eat? Okay, good. Then tell me why food is an essential part of our life? Food helps you play. Food helps you work and food helps you think and play. Okay, gives energy also. Okay, here you can see one machine that asks good fuel is meant for a machine. Likewise, we good. Okay, here you can see some of the mainly five types of nutrients. What all that tell me? Okay, then tell me what is the another name of fats and carbohydrate?
Energy
giving food. Okay, what is the another name of protein?
Bodybuilding
food. Okay, then tell me what is the another name of
vitamins and minerals? Protective food. Okay, shall we move on to the each type of nutrients? First one is the carbohydrate. Tell me, what is the main function of carbohydrate? Okay, it gives the energy. Okay, good. Then carbohydrate is classified into two types. What are the starches and sugars? Okay, then tell me the brain you have to add that in your day-to-day life diet. Okay, then vegetable and food, 30% of vegetables and food you should add that in your day-to-day life diet, and 20% of milk and meat and fish you have to add that in your day-to-day life balanced diet. Okay, then 10% of fat also you should add that in your day-to-day life diet. Okay, then along with this healthy diet, you should be also needed to be physically active. Exercise makes us feel good. It improves our blood circulation and keeps our bones and muscles very strong. So, eat right and drink plenty of water. Be active and live a healthy life. Okay, thank you. Thank you, students.
अगर हम खाते गए तो हमारे लिए harmful भी है, ठीक है? तो first वाले से second column का C match करेंगे. Okay. Now when we come to third column, so let's see which will match actually. The first वाले पे देखते हैं. We throw away the solid component, okay? ये थोड़ा सा ज़्यादा appropriate लग रहा है. बाकी दो को भी देख लेते हैं. Please keep your mic off. Somebody's mic is on. Keep your mic off. Okay. Second one, what is given? We throw away the impurities. ठीक है, ये भी match कर रहा है कि impurity को हम throw कर देते हैं. ठीक है. Then third one is we use both the components. So, ये सही नहीं है. अगर आप stone remove कर रहे हो rice से, तो आप stone को थोड़ी ना use कर रहे हो. Only you are using the rice. Okay, तो both the component थोड़ी ना use कर रहे हैं. तो ये third वाला तो बिल्कुल not नहीं match करेगा. Okay. Now first और second में अगर हम देखें, तो first वाला ज़्यादा appropriate match कर रहा है, क्योंकि stones they are actually the solid component. Okay, तो we are actually throwing them. Right? We are separating rice and stone. Okay, so we are actually throwing the stone or the solid component.
सो हियर बेसिकली ये हिंदी मतलब है राष्ट्रीय मतलब नेशनल पोषण मतलब इट इज रिलेटेड टू न्यूट्रिशन एंड माह मीन्स दिस होल मंथ इज रिलेटेड टू न्यूट्रिशन और वी कैन से इट न्यूट्रिशन मंथ बेसिकली ओके सो अवर टॉपिक इज एज यू आर एबल टू सी द इमेज ओके इट इज अ कंप्लीट थाली ओके सो इन डे टू डे लाइफ वी आर हैविंग यू नो At least we have three time meal we are taking, okay, right from the breakfast and the lunch and then dinner, okay. In between, we can munch some snacks as well, okay. Now, if you notice in this thali or whatever things we are using in our thali in daily, day-to-day life or daily basis, okay. So here we are not using, same type of food every day, okay. Not every day we are using bhindi or we are having bhindi aaj, on Monday also, on Tuesday also, on Wednesday also. Aisa nahi karte hum. Okay. So what we are doing, we are, in our plate or in our thali, what we are doing, we are keeping varieties of food. Okay. Now in this thali image, you are able to see there is chapati, there is salad, okay. Pickles are there, chutney are there. Some dessert, gulab jamun is there, varieties of vegetables, then including rice, papad, and what we say, chaach or lassi. Okay, so why we are doing all these things, why we are keeping the variety of food, so that from each food we can get different types of nutrition. ओके हमको ये वैरायटी में हम क्यों खाना अपनी थाली में लेते हैं क्यों सिर्फ हम चपाती चपाती नहीं ईट करते सो दैट वी आर गेटिंग यू नो डिफरेंट वैरायटीज ऑफ न्यूट्रिशन और न्यूट्रिएंट्स फ्रॉम डिफरेंट वैरायटीज ऑफ फूड ओके नाउ नेक्स्ट इज सो हियर कम्स द फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन दैट व्हाट इज फूड. फूड से हम क्या समझते हैं. ओके सो फूड इज बेसिकली यू नो समथिंग व्हिच इज एडिबल जो हम खा सकते हैं एंड फ्रॉम दैट थिंग वेट something which we can eat, okay, and something which gives us nutrition basically, wo food mein count hota hai. Okay, so as you're able to read, any substance which is consumed to provide nutritional support to for an organism, okay, koi bhi organism hai, you know, not only humans are consuming food, plants, animals, different living organisms are consuming food, okay, and the only reason is because we are getting different types of nutrition through our food. Okay, now here comes the nutrition word. The nutrition matlab kya hota hai? The process of consuming nutrients required for the growth and development of our body and to obtain energy. Okay, whatever food we are consuming, okay, from that food we are getting different types of nutrients. Okay, so what those nutrients are doing, they are supporting us for in our growth and development. Okay, they are providing us energy. Okay, so this is the whole definition of nutrition. Isi ko hum kya bolte hain, nutrition. All the nutrients which gives us growth and which are required for growth and development, okay, and which is required for giving us the energy, okay, unko hum kya bolte hain, nutrition mein count karte hain. Okay, now next is, okay, here comes what are the importance of healthy food for kids. Okay, why we are consuming food, what do you understand? You can interact. Why we are consuming food? Yes. What is the role of food? What food does for our body?
Ma'am, it give us energy. It give us
growth. Energy. Okay. Then
body.
Ma'am, it gives proteins, fibers.
Okay. Different nutrients. Okay.
Ma'am, different nutrients. Ma'am, energy.
Energy. Okay.
Ma'am, calcium also.
Okay.
Ma'am, for diseases.
For diseases. Get reading from diseases. Okay.
Ma'am,
yeah.
For digestion.
For digestion. Okay. Okay. As you're able to see, yeah, as you're able to see, these are the few importance of having the food. Okay. First of all, it provides us energy for performing various physical activities. It helps in growth, okay, growth of our body, matlab jo hamari body structure wise ya height wise badhti hai, okay, each year or each day, okay, uske liye ye help karta hai for growth of our body, growth and development of our body. Okay. Then for the proper functioning of our body, matlab if our brain is working, nervous system is working, digestive system is working, respiratory system is working, whatever system is working, it's because of food we are taking. Okay, uske liye bhi food important hai. Then it is helping us in get ridding from various diseases, matlab immune system ko boost karne ke liye, badhane ke liye bhi food jo hai wo essential hai. Okay, so these are the few roles of food. Then here comes the sources of food. Okay, you already studied about this. What are the different sources of food? So basically two sources of food are there, plants and animals. Okay, and you know, from plants also we are, you know, for in certain plants we are eating different parts of those plants. Okay, right from root, stem, leaves, okay, then flower, fruits, etc. Okay, and here animals also, certain animals they are serving or they are acting as food for us. For example, from different cattle like cow and buffalo, we are getting milk. Okay, so we can make different milk products. Okay, then hen we are eating as you know, for the chicken purpose. Fishes we are eating. Okay, prawns we are eating. So like this, we are eating different certain animals as our food. Okay, so these are the few sources of food. Then here comes the different types of nutrients. Okay, so what are the different types of nutrients are there? What you studied already?
Carbohydrates,
Protein, we studied about the macronutrients and micronutrients. Okay, so they are the different types of nutrients. Okay, so macronutrients which our body required in huge amount. Okay, so carbohydrate, proteins, fats, these are the macronutrients. These are the types of macronutrients. Okay, similarly, what you just said about the micronutrients, minerals and vitamins, they are the micronutrients. Means our body required them in very less amount. Okay, isliye they are known as the micronutrients. So minerals and vitamins, they are the micronutrients.
Had your breakfast?
Yes.
Then tell me, what did you eat?
We eat oats, milk, bread.
Okay, good. Then tell me, why the food is an essential part of our life?
It gives us the energy
and nutrition to grow and
It gives the energy to play, it gives the energy to work, it gives the energy to think and learn. Here you can see, as a good fuel is best for a machine, likewise, good food is best for our body also. Okay, then tell me, what is the main five types of nutrients? Yes, then tell me, what is the another name of fats and carbohydrates? Carbohydrates also called energy giving food. Then protein also called
body building food.
Okay. Then vitamins and minerals also called
protective water and fiber.
Okay. Shall we move on to the each type of nutrient? First of all, the carbohydrate. What is the main function of carbohydrate?
It gives sources of energy
to our body. Carbohydrates are classified into two kinds. What all that?
Starches and sugars.
Okay, here we can move on to the second major types of nutrient, that is fat. Fat also, the main function of fat also, they are giving more energy to our body. Here you can see some of the sources of fat. But also the third major nutrient is protein. The main function of protein, it helps to build our body. It helps to maintain our body. It helps to repair our body, such like muscles, skin, blood and bones. Okay, then it helps to grow our body also. Here you can see some of the different stages of growing. Okay, you can see vitamins and minerals. What is the main function of vitamins and minerals?
Okay.
The vitamins and minerals always protect our body from diseases. It gives strong teeth, it gives strong bones, and it gives good vision. Okay, here you can see some of the sources of vitamins. Whenever we are adding these sources of vitamin in our day-to-day life diet plan, that time we will protect from diseases. Okay, here you can see the water also the essential for our good health diet. Okay, what is the main function of water? Okay, water gives health in keeping our skin and hairs in good condition. Also, the water gives the digestion process also. In everyday life, you have to drink 2 liters of water. Okay, if we do not eat enough energy containing food, mean we will feel very tired. Likewise, if we do not eat enough protein, means we will not be able to grow properly. Likewise, vitamins and minerals also. But if we eat too much of energy containing food, mean we will become overweight. What is the disease name of overweight?
Obesity.
Because of these reasons, we have to maintain the balanced diet. In that balanced diet, we have to add all the nutrients. Okay, all the nutrients in a right quantities. Okay, here you can see one of the guide, that is food pyramid. Okay, in that food pyramid shows what food we should be eat and how much of food we should be eat. The left side you can see the balanced diet. Okay, the bottom of the balanced diet you can see grains. 40% of grain you have to add it in your day-to-day diet. Then 30% of vegetables and fruit you have to add it. Then 20% of milk, meat, fish, egg you have to add it in your diet plan, and 10% of fat item you have to add it in your balanced diet. Please be needed the physical activity also. Exercise always make us a feel good and it improves our blood circulation and keeps our bones and muscles very strong.
Month September, we are going to celebrate a national nutrition. So what is this national nutrition and why this topic came now? Because of this national nutrition. Now, I will show you in this session, I will cover two major topics, and that are, first one is deficiencies diseases and second one is malnutrition. Okay, so first we will start with the deficiency diseases. Okay, nutrition, national nutrition, in this I am going to cover these two major topics. First one is deficiency diseases and second one is malnutrition. I hope. Okay, so deficiency diseases. What is deficiency diseases? Okay, here are some pictures for you, and with this picture I hope that something is coming in your mind. So what is this deficiency diseases? So deficiency diseases is nothing. A deficiency diseases can be defined as a disease which is caused by the lack of essential nutrients or dietary elements such as vitamins and minerals in the human body. Deficiency disease examples are vitamin B1 deficiency causes because of vitamin B deficiency, what type of diseases will occur? That is beriberi. Okay, this beriberi is a name of a deficiency diseases which is caused by vitamin B1. Then lack of iron. Iron is what? It is a mineral. Okay, so lack of iron in the body can lead to anemia. Now what are the types of the deficiency diseases? That also we will see. So here I am sharing, there are two types of the deficiency diseases. Deficiency diseases are of two types. First one is vitamin deficiency diseases and second one is mineral deficiency diseases. So what is this vitamin deficiency diseases? It is a condition of a long term lack of vital amines in our body. Okay, if there is a less intake of vitamin, then the condition is called primary deficiency, and if the reason behind deficiency is malabsorption of vitamins due to a disorder, it is called a secondary deficiency. Okay, vitamin deficiency can result in disease such as beriberi and pellagra. Okay, so this is all about the vitamin deficiency diseases. Now what happened with the mineral diseases? Vitamins are vitamin A, B, C, D, B1. So these are the vitamins. Okay, now minerals are what? Iron, calcium, phosphorus, these are the minerals. So if there is a deficiency in the mineral, so what happened? So mineral deficiency, minerals are nutrients, okay, first of all, that the human body need. Mineral are nutrients that the human body needs in order to function properly. A mineral deficiency occurs when the body doesn't obtain or absorb the required amount of mineral. It can happen slowly over a time of various reasons. This can be increased need for minerals in the body, lack of minerals in the diet, etc. The deficiency of minerals can lead to several health problems, and for example, deficiency of iron can result in anemia. So this we had studied. I hope all of you are taking this screenshot.
Yes.
Now, as I told you that we will cover only two topics, that is deficiency diseases and the malnutrition. So now we will see the malnutrition. Come to this point, malnutrition. Okay, just a minute, children. Lack of sufficient nutrients in the body. Okay, that is because of the malnutrition. Malnutrition occurs when the body doesn't get enough nutrients. Causes include of poor diet, digestive conditions, or another disease. Symptoms are, what are the symptoms of the malnutrition? So symptoms are fatigue, dizziness, and weight loss. Untreated malnutrition can cause physical or mental disability. Now we will see what are the causes of the malnutrition. So there are five causes of the malnutrition. Okay, so that is, first one is a low intake of food. So what is the low intake? When we will take food but in low quantity, so that what happened here. So some people develop malnutrition because there is not enough food available, or because they have difficulty eating or absorbing nutrients. This can happen as a result of cancer, liver cancer, conditions that can cause nausea or make it difficult to eat or swallow. So this is the first cause, and mobility problem we will see now. So factors that can affect a person eating habit and potentially lead to malnutrition include, first, being unable to leave the house or reach a store to buy a food. So see how the food is important for us. Then finding it physically difficult to prepare meals. The person, those who are suffering from the malnutrition, they cannot even though prepare food properly. Then
why should we not waste food? Do you waste food?
No, ma'am, never.
No, ma'am.
Very. So how can we avoid wasting food?
By giving them to beggars.
Yes, you can give them to beggars little bit, if anything extra.
Only that much food which
we have to eat. We can take that much food that we have to eat.
Yes, only take little food you take, so that you can eat it completely. If you need more, you can take it, isn't it? You can take it more. If you, very good. So this is how you can save food. Okay, do not waste food at all. Because why we should not waste? Because there are so many children, millions of people who does not have food to eat. So you can give it to them, they will feel like happy. Why should we give them food? Because they will get one-time food, or because of your food, they will be remaining healthy, as well as they will feel like happy, isn't it? Anna? So it is our duty to give them food, okay, to the poor. Now, how many of you have gardens, kitchen garden?
Yes, I have them.
Very good. So you can send me pictures of it, okay? You can send me pictures of it, and you can show me the what all garden you have and which all vegetables you have. Am I right? So this is clear to you, children?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Very good. And what did you get from today's class? What all things, one by one, you can share. Okay. So Mansirat, what about what did you understand from today's class? That is,
ma'am, we should never waste food.
Very good. We should never waste food. Why, Anushka? Why should not we waste food? Why should not we waste food?
Ma'am, because
We should not waste. How much amount of food we should take?
That much we only have to eat.
How much is required? You must take that. Yes, Shailaja, do you want to share something? या अथर परिहार इज शेयरिंग हिज किचन गार्डन. जस्ट शो मी, आई एम पुटिंग ऑफ माई कैमरा. जस्ट शो मी व्हाट किचन गार्डन यू हैव. यस,
राष्ट्रीय पोषण माह. ओके, इट इज रिटन ओवर देयर दैट. एनी आइडिया अबाउट इट
मैम? टू प्रमोट इक्वालिटी.
टू प्रमोट इक्वालिटी, ओके. अपार्ट फ्रॉम दैट, as you are studying, you know what are the benefits, why we are having balanced diet, or why we should have balanced diet, what are the importance of balanced diet, why we should include all the fruits and vegetables and dal, chapati, sabji, green vegetables, all these things we should eat, why we should eat all these things, I hope you all know. Okay, but the unprivileged section or the poor people or the poor children, they don't know the importance of that balanced diet. Apart from that, they are not getting proper diet also. Okay, so just to promote that unprivileged section also get proper diet, and they should also know what is the importance of balanced diet, this Rashtriya Poshan Mah was started by the CBSE, and it is just like an awareness camp that you people just promote these things. You can go to unprivileged sections and you just promote all these things. Okay, why they should have good quality of food, either they don't, it may possible some of the children don't get, if they are not getting that, so it's your duty to serve them, to serve the society. If one child, if in our class 50 children are there, if 50 children can give one plate or can feed one children, then at least 50 children will get good balanced diet. So just to promote that thing, yes, Neil, to you, that at least you give food to one child and click the photograph, and that photograph you have to send to me, and we're going to upload it in CBSE website, so that they'll know that our children, our school children are working towards this direction. So because of that,
Mem
B1.
I'm
sending. Very good. Next one. Next. This experiment you already did in class 7, chapter 2. Third one. Sorry, third question.
Which food provides service?
This is very common thing. Next one.
A1.
Very good. Next one. This experiment fats. Also you did in class 6.
Fat.
Next. Fast.
Ma'am, A.
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 A one.
That is wrong, actually.
C one.
Ma'am, D.
D prime one. D.
Ma'am, D one.
Think and
D one.
Read the question properly and then give me the answer.
Ma'am, D option.
Next one.
And first option, legumes and pulses.
And legumes and pulses.
Next one.
Ma'am, first one.
Ma'am, vitamins and minerals.
Vitamins and minerals.
Vitamins and minerals. C.
It's not.
I'm protein. I'm protein.
I'm protein.
It's again wrong.
I'm fat.
Better think, which nutrient form a major part of our daily diet? When you will not have carbohydrate, you're not getting energy. So how you will do your work? Next one.
Protein rich food.
You can see the reason also. Next one.
Fruits and green vegetables.
See, awesome.
Next one.
Vitamin D.
Vitamin D.
Good. Next one.
Potatoes.
Rice.
Potato.
Next one. Isme they asked food, so we can just check.
Rice
and potatoes. To understand why we need food, what are the basic nutrients which we are getting from the food, as well as what is the meaning of balanced diet, what happen when we will not have balanced diet. So I hope.
Hello everyone, myself Pratik Kumar Singh of class 9C, and today I am here to say some of advantages of eating brinjal. Brinjal contains high fiber content and has low calories, making it must add to any healthy diet. With its high fiber content, brinjal moves through the digestive tract slowly and can make you more saturated. Here you can see the brinjal flowers. Its bud contains a polygrain, which after that becomes after a few years it becomes a brinjal. Thank you and have a good day.
Everyone, I'm Preet Shahzadpuri and today I will tell you about two trees, coconut and about mango. This is the mango tree. As you know, mango is rich in fibers and vitamin C. It also helps you to open your skin pores and keeps your skin healthy. Let's talk about the coconut tree. So this is the coconut tree and coconut tree keeps us hydrated, refreshing, helps us in weight loss and keeps us healthy. So you should also drink coconut water. So this is the coconut tree. I hope you liked it. Thank you so much for watching. Goodbye.
Importance of vitamins.